My name is Yogi Tom Kelly. Can I ask you a very direct question? What do you want? What do you want? What are you going after today? And then can I ask you the second direct question? Then what? Then what? Then what do you want? You go after what you're going to do today or what you want today? Then what? And then what? And then what? Good morning, Brooke. Good morning. Thank you so much, Soul Rebel, for being this powerhouse, this lighthouse, and this love house sitting right next to me right now, beaming to the world, being open as a channel to just express the infinite and let the infinite flow through us so that everyone gets a sense that we're all in the flow together. But then what? That's our question today. We need to be just as excited to die today, because that's the then what that you'll get to the at the end will be the what. The what's next that you don't have a clue about, right? Although you have a memory of many transitions after a physical life. Many. You do have the divine memory. It's called Smriti. But listen, what about that then what? Are you ready for the then what? Or what's next, really? Huh? And what would you have then? What will you feel like then? Will all your accomplishments or lack of or regrets for that didn't happen and all this stuff, will that come into play when it's the end of the line, baby, and it's time to let go of this physical instrument, huh? And all your plans and all those thoughts and all those loved ones and not so loved ones and problems? What next, huh? Then what? Then what? You know, we as the Soul Rebels in the Love Force Revolution and the GitaStudy.com, we live in the then what? We live in then what then? What then is when we begin, huh? We're invisible, we're intangible. We are almighty and all powerful. We are the cosmic soul, the immortal soul, one with the infinite spirit. Now that's the place to begin life. That's the place to begin today, don't you think? That gives you a bit of wisdom. Because honestly, you get everything that you want. Let's say what do you want? You want the better house. You want the retreat place. You want the school for your children. Okay, but then how are you going to be on the inside? You might have a little satisfaction, but you're still going to be seeking, doll. You're still going to be needing something. You're still going to be, without source, you're always going to be needing for that elusive something else that will never give you what you are looking for. All right? So let's just get real down to business now and go straight to the end in mind, which is the beginning of the wisdom awakening within us. Hello, Natalie. Hello, Amanda. You know, we're getting right fit for the infinite right now. We really are. Right? We're going to discipline our minds today. We are. So that we can really get to the bottom line of what we want. And what we want is that to be as just as excited to die today as for that next thing that you want. In fact, be more excited to die today to those needs and those wants that are just these outward ones. So you can die to the outward ones so you can bust open and inflame those inner ones, okay? Doesn't that sound, hello, Jeff, hello, Christine, thank you, Rebels. We're all sitting as powerhouses right now. We're all conducting. We're all inducing the divine presence right now so we can spread it out as one light and one love to our world. Honestly. And we're getting fit to the infinite. Hello, Kathy. Oh my gosh, thank you for joining, because all that you are is just mixed and blended and is morphing into all that we are, and then that's all going to be all that is, okay? And we're going to hold a space for our world today that you probably didn't even consider holding. Hello, Steve. I'm so excited about everything, but I'm more excited to die to the excitement that I have for the outer things. No, did you get that? I'm so excited about the outer things and what source is going to help me to manifest in our world and what I can do for each of you to anything and everything to help you feel better, to help you feel more special, to help you feel more centered, to help you feel more like you are right on track and on beam, or just feel love, baby, right? I'll just love you. I'll just be a soul friend. You can rent me as a soul friend, okay? Or make a donation to the Love for it, and I'll be your soul friend, right? No, honestly, but I am just as excited to die than I am to have anything manifest in this world, even the best of things. Because what? I'm going to go somewhere else. What's next? Then what, man? It's the then what that holds the real power. Because when I can get into that invisible, intangible soul consciousness and oneness with spirit power flowing through me, then it's may thy will be done. Then it's the divine will be done through me. Then I'm just free. I'm not have any stake in anything, man, except I have the stake in who I am and whose I am in the oneness everlasting. That's the flag I put down. That's why I'm dying to everything else. Isn't that cool? Aren't you just as excited to die today to the thoughts and the feelings and your desires and everything that this world could offer you? Are you still the one that's going to be tempted by the next little thing, the next little bauble, the next little glimmering jewel, piece of jewelry, the next little good movie, the next whatever, are you? To lose your center for that? Or are you going to be the great best dyer on the planet? Hello, Raphael. Oh, so we're going to, oh my mind, learn self-control. Oh my mind, learn self-control. Senses, oh my mind, learn self-control. Oh my mind, learn self-control. And go not in the house of senses. No, go not in the house of senses. Souls on fire. Don't we really have a mission? That's why we'll control our minds. That's why we are willing to die today, so that the then what becomes the here and now, right? That I am more in touch with the invisible, intangible, the loving presence, my supreme goal, the purpose of existence, and I am manifesting this next thing that I want. That frees you up, baby. That gives Source full permission to work through you. And you can be so happy and so detached at the same time. You can be living life to the fullest while you're completely dead to the expectations and to the desires that Source is manifesting through you. But you are more fully alive than ever before. Hello, welcome to your true nature. Hello, Joel, I'm meaning to call you, Joel. We got some serious spiritual business to talk about. We've got our instructions. We got our mission possible instructions from the Most High, Joel, and we all do. Amy's in, and Raphael is in, and we're getting some other core rebels that are going to just form the most incredible nucleus of soul light and soul power and harmony and brotherhood and sisterhood that's imaginable to have in this physical domain. How does that sound? And anyone else? You're all welcome. This is not an exclusive club. If anyone wants to throw in some love equity and some joy equity, equity and the passion of your soul into helping spread this message. Look at the message. Whatever this message is, I think it's a message of joy. It's a message of hope. It's a message of, hey, man, there's so much more than meets the eye, right? And on and on and on. Please join us. You know, write me at tava@soulofyoga.com and let me know, or message me here, but let me know. Come on, you need something different. Everyone needs something different. That's a bigger cause. That's a huge cause that they can throw themselves into, because that's the surest way to overcome your problems and overcome your depression. You know, the greatest way is to think of others. So thinking of others, thinking of the how we can serve others, how we can serve the divine, is the surest way out of your stuff. I promise you, because you forget the little self. It's only, you only have problems and depressions and all that stuff and lack consciousness because you're thinking about yourself all the time. Now, we got to burn that. We got to die to that today. And then go to the then what, which is the here and now of this amazing cosmic presence and loving presence and divine potential, right? And then we can go ahead and start, you know, conquering our lower nature, becoming the soul hero. Hello, Nani. I'm loving this energy every day. I am loving what's up, and I don't care exactly to know how and what and all the duckies in the row about it. All I know, I can feel it. I'm a feeler, man. All I can do is feel it, you know. When my heart feels better, I just follow that. When my heart doesn't feel better, I don't make any decisions. No, not when my heart isn't. I know, because I work in my heart. I live in my heart. Oh, I know when my heart has got the green light, and I know when it's got the yellow light, and I certainly know when it's got the red light, so that I don't make any choices when my heart isn't on green light, baby. I'm just got to be full tilt green light, and then I am in, you know. If it's orange, I am going to get more in tune and do what I need to do to die to everything, so that I can really live to the incredible, impeccable divine guidance, man. GDI, guiding divine intelligence. GDI, man, that's as good as GPS, God's perfect system, right? Don't we all want to be guided to that perfect intuitive thing that's in tune with the divine plan? Don't we? So come on, let's get control in this mind so we don't go into the house of these outer things that we have attachments and desires for and forget the divine plan and being instruments of the infinite, right? Oh, my mind, learn self-control. Oh, my mind, learn self-control and go not in the house of senses. No, go not in the house of senses. Oh, my mind, learn self-control. Go not in the house of the senses, no, go not in the house of the... We want to go to where Nani is saying that we should go. You know, we want to go into the heart. It's the most sacred place to be, the one beloved of forever. I mean, your lover, your cosmic lover and your best friend is right there inside your heart. That's why we would choose the heart over the senses. We're not going into the house of senses because you can't get any kind of, can't get no, satisfaction. That's what Mick Jagger really meant. Call him up. Send him a text. Send him a tweet. That's what he meant. Can't get no satisfaction in the house of senses. Well, I'm giving him the benefit of the doubt, okay? We got to go into the heart, right? Because it's time to get fit for the infinite. Oh, it's time to get fit for the infinite. And wake up as soul. Wake up as soul. Yeah. What an amazing day. It's an amazing day because you are amazing, because our hearts are connected, because we're moving into a bigger heart, right? We're moving into feeling that there is a bigger us, not the little tiny. I'm telling you, the person who's wrapped up in themselves as is a very small package, right? And has serious I problems. It's just I. It's just me. But the we is such an expansive letter, because look at the we. It's this open. It's inclusive. It's this letting this cosmic power and light and energy and love embrace the universal that we are and everyone is, so that all our brothers and sisters on the planet from all the different races and colors and creeds can experience what we're experiencing right here and now on Facebook Live. Woohoo! Yeah, baby! Lisa Kelly Clark has shared your video. That's my girl. That's my girl. Bit by bit today, Clark. Bit by bit, little things, we come out from the closet, right? Bit by bit, we don't let fear. You know that guy, Ibn Alexander, the one who wrote the book, The Proof of Heaven? He was such an atheist. He was such a just a brain surgeon. He was just by the book. He didn't believe anything until he went into that coma for a week and pretty much went to the other side for a long visit in the inner worlds. Well, read his book, Proof of Heaven, okay? He's changed, man. He's going around the world saying, hey, kids, science will never ever come close. Not ever, ever come close to what I experience and what you experience and what is the reality. But he said three things remember always. This is what was taught to him early in his near-death experience. He said, have no fear. This is what the presence told him. Have no fear. You can't do any wrong, and I love you so much. You are so loved. You can't do any wrong, and have no fear. Come on, would you guys all put that down on your mirrors today? Would you put that down as a note on your cell phone? Would you write it out? Would you remember that and repeat it, right? I am so loved. I can't do wrong, and I have no fear. I have no fear. There's nothing to fear. I can't do wrong, and I am so loved. There's nothing to fear. I can't do wrong. Whatever I choose, I can't do wrong, man. Why? Because right and wrong is relative. You are so loved. Like yesterday's stream, so amazingly special, man. So amazingly in the most unique relationship with the source of all that is. That's only got eyes on you. It doesn't care about everything else. It only has eyes on you so that you will have a one-on-one beyond special relationship every second of existence. Kids, listen, we were not meant to come down here to suffer. We were not meant to come down here and forget God. We weren't. I swear, Source did not have that in the plan. He figured that we would be so wanting to remember and so wanting to stay in that bliss oneness that we would watch this movie of creation and just like watch a movie and then go back into the bosom of the spirit bliss, right? And then when we needed some entertainment, we'd watch this movie. But we'd go back in the bliss. We'd watch the movie with the Supreme and with all the divine qualities of our soul. And with each other, we'll just watch the entertainment of what's going on in creation. And then we go back into the bosom of bliss, right? And we have the party going on and everything. I swear, trust yourself in this. Trust your soul. You will know one day. And only you will know. You will know and none else will know. And everybody is going to know one day. And then we're all going to be knowing that God did not create this world for us to be in suffering. Okay? All right? I mean, you would think that we would suffer, we're going to forget and suffer, but we'd get right back. You burn your finger and go, I'm not putting my hand in the fire again, right? I'm not going to go down this road. I just had four divorces, and now I'm not so doing so good on my fifth wife, right? But I mean, come on, when are you, how much suffering do we need to have? God didn't plan on that, man. Figured that we were smarter than we are because he created us with infinite wisdom. So of course he would think that we're smarter than who we are, right? But he didn't estimate the power of his delusion and Divine Mother's Maya that has us forget all this like that. Have us throw out a really good life quality moments and you made some effort and you feel a little happier and we can throw it away on a dime like that because of one impulse, one nasty sentence that we could say to someone can destroy a friendship for a lifetime. One move where my compulsions and my impulses and my lust takes over, and then that wipes out friendships too. That wipes out everything that you built in this house of sand, man, in this house of senses, right? So what is, which is our subject this morning, let's don't even go there. Let's be as excited today day to die to all our thoughts and feelings so we can live in joy together and come together and create a new world. And I just call it the Love Force Revolution. Let me know your skills and talent. Why would I want us to all co-create together? Because we're so darn happy together. Because I'll tell you, my GitaStudy.com, the Rebels, we haven't even all been on the video chat together. We love each other beyond scope, and we have hardly met each other physically. What does that say? I mean, that's the joy factor. That is what I'm talking about, people. That is why I'm saying it. I'm so excited to die rather than I am to manifest for the divine here. Because the divine will manifest what can manifest through you, and that's fine. But I don't care what it is. I just feel the joy of the divine, and I feel the brothers and sisters with all of you, right? Right? Isn't that true? Live today like there's no tomorrow. Love everyone like a brother. Let's live today like there's no tomorrow. Love everyone like a sister. Come on, let's love. Let's love everyone. 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 Just like a brother and sister. Just like a brother and sister. Just like a brother and sister. Supreme intelligence. I know. I thought you were going to say Nani supreme indulgence, which is okay. Enjoy it. It's love, 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 love. Exactly. Supreme, if that's the word, because it's hard to see without my glasses, but I think you said supreme intelligence, or it's also to my eyes, supreme indulgence, indulgence in the supreme joy and the bliss and happiness. Live today like there's no tomorrow. Love everyone like a brother. Live today like there's no tomorrow. Love everyone like a sister. You know, this is it. We just have today to love each other with everything we've got. No bars held, man. Nothing held back. It's just burn the boats behind you and let's love. We don't have time to be worried about a problem. We don't have time to fix a problem. We don't have time for anything else. We don't have time to manifest. Because really, think about it. You've got this dream and you're going to build something and you're working all your butt off every day, you know, 5 days a week, sometimes 6 weeks into the... And then what? Then what? What is your satisfaction factor? What is it? Some out there goals, this elusive something else around the corner that you're working for? No, it's inside, man. If you're not happy beyond expectations now, if you're not bursting with joy now, it ain't going to be there after you've sweat and tears, blood, sweat and tears to manifest a building or to have a little higher raise in your salary. No, that's where people get ripped off, man. Then what? Then what? So you get what you want. Then what? Then what? Then what? Keep asking yourself that until you realize what you really want is truth. What you really want is self-loving. All right. All right. Let's once more. Let's live today like there's no tomorrow. Love everyone like a brother. Let's live today like there's no tomorrow. Love everyone like a sister. Come on, promise me, right here in this chorus, sing this with me. Come on, let's love everyone. 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 Hey, Nani, thank you so much. Just like a brother and sister. Just like a brother and sister. Come on, let's love everyone. 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 sister, just like a brother and sister, just like a brother and sister, just like a brother and sister. Thank you, everyone. Thank you for even being on. Thank you for just imbibing this stuff. Thank you for just soaking up the vibrations, because they're going to go way deeper than skin deep, man. They're going to go way deeper. They're gonna spark the heart of you. They're going to spark the core of you. They're going to spark this infinite fire that each of us are as this immortal soul that's just so specially loved by the Spirit that it made creation just so you can be in an intimate relationship with the Supreme, with the One Beloved, the Supreme. It's like the movie King and I, right? The Yul Brynner, bald-headed guy. The Infinite and I. Can you imagine that you can hold hands with the Infinite today? Can you imagine that you can walk along and talk just like you do to your friends or whatever? You can drive with the Infinite in your car, sitting right next to you, really as you. Hello, Joanne. Well, welcome, girl. You know, if you ever need a fix, Joanne, you know, if you ever want to save yourself some bucks from whatever therapy or whatever kind of outer education you're getting in life, come to this love stream and just soak up the vibes, baby. And just feel who you are and give up the ghost, could you? Could you drop dead, Joanne, huh? Could you, we're talking about, be as excited today to die to your limitation, to die to your outer self, to die to all this striving for something that when you get to the end result, you're not satisfied really, and then you want something else and strive and strive and strive. When the reality is, just drop dead, give up the ghost right now, give up all your desires for outward things, control your senses, don't go into the five senses, and let's get fit for the Infinite, right? Let's wake up as soul. I'm telling you, you'll be much more happier if you have a daily dose of this street, man. I promise you, that's the only reason I'm here. I'm only here to share the joy and share the love. And if it's something that you might be considering could help you in life, then come on and just imbibe it. And then, you know, we're going to get addicted to it. And then the addiction, we're going to stay together more and connect together. I mean, even people live in the same house. Even husband and wife don't really connect, right? Everyone's too busy for the then what? For what's next? I got to go do this for something, right? Well, what if that something is already here and now? The abundance is already here and now. I think you guys are reading me, right? I think you got it loud and clear. One spirit heart, beloved, one spirit heart, beloved. There's one love, okay? One spirit heart. Inside your heart is the goal. If you got a destination for what's next in your life, get inside this heart. And look at the thoughts you think today. Have a printout of them. And what are they? You'll be so depressed if you had a printout of your thoughts and your desires and the calibrated by spirit and the intuition of your soul. Okay, was this desire on track for liberation? Was this desire on track to live in the heart in a romance with the cosmic beloved or not? You would see that script, we could just burn it. And that's why we got to die and burn it right now. Don't ever trust this delusion. Don't ever count on this delusion. This ain't your home. Come on, let's get into the one spirit heart. Beloved, sing the beloveds. One spirit heart, everyone. Beloved, one spirit heart. Beloved, one spirit heart. Beloved, beloved's in my heart, beloved's in your heart, beloved's in every heart. Beloved's in my heart, beloved's in your heart, beloved's in every heart. Only one love, oh my beloved. Sing the oh my beloved, it's only one love. Here you go. Oh my beloved, only one love. My beloved, could there only be one love in my heart? Could there only be one love in your heart? Could there only be one love in every heart? Could yes, I would say yes, exclamation, 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 exclamation. One spirit heart, beloved, one spirit heart. Sing, beloved, one spirit heart, beloved, one spirit heart. Beloved, beloved's in my heart, beloved's in your heart, beloved's in every heart. Sing, oh, beloved's in my heart, beloved's in your heart, beloved's in every heart. Only one love, only one love, and it's my beloved. Oh, my beloved, only one love, a sacred heart. Oh, my beloved spirit heart, only one love. Oh, my beloved, only one love. My beloved. Our one beloved lives in all of our hearts. So the one beloved is the one love that we're all seeking, and it lives in all of our hearts, and we live in the one love. Could there only be one love in my heart? Could there only be one love in your heart? Could there only be one love in every heart? Could there only be one love in my heart? Could there only be one love in your heart? Could there only be one love in every heart? Could there only be one beloved? Let's just all sing this last part together. One spirit heart, beloved, one spirit heart, beloved, one spirit heart, beloved, one spirit heart, beloved. All right? Hey, you guys, listen. Please give yourself the biggest benefits all day long of the doubts. If the doubts come in for anything that seems more important than what we're vibing with right now and what we're talking, go back and watch the stream. I watch these streams. I just don't allow any other space in my head. I've emptied it. It's taken me almost 40 into my 49th year now to empty my mind of all the garbage. You know, I've had to take out the garbage, man, and I bring in the new software. So if this kind of idea, this energy, with the words mesh or don't, but feel the vibe and just get it fill in the brain today. So let's don't let the doubts come in. Let's just follow the wisdom guidance, the GDI, guiding divine intelligence, all right? And the GPS, God's perfect system that's operating. Because we want to be totally impeccably in tune with that one beloved, right? To that one cosmic beloved. We want to be impeccably tuned. This is the absolute all-knowing center is in the heart. It's intuitive guidance at its finest, man. When we follow love, we follow the joy, we follow getting, you know, broader and more empathy and more compassion, and all, we follow that, we are on the beam. And it's not even us then. It's not even us. It's never been us. The less you can make it about yourself, the better. Okay? Because somewhere, someone is always loving me. Somehow you know my name. Somewhere, someone is always loving me. And somehow you know my name. Oh, can you be for real? Can you be forever? Are you really the one for me? Might ask that question, you know? Is the invisible the intangible? What most people say, that's not rational, that's not practical. Get down to earth. Yes, you get down and anchored in earth when you're anchored in the eternal. That is the real grounding in the earth plane, okay? But it isn't to be practical without the thought of the divine. It's not to be rational if you lose the love in your heart, right? No, we are guided by GTI, guiding divine intelligence, and the GPS of a heart that's on fire. The heart that is inflamed with love. That's us right there. Somewhere, someone is always loving me. Somehow you know my name. Somewhere, someone is always loving me, and somehow you know my name. Oh, can you be for real? Can you be forever? Are you really the one for me? Yeah, yeah. Oh, can you be for real? Can you be forever? Are you really the one for me? I sing my song, I pour my heart. I sing my song, I pour my heart. We're never, ever apart. I sing my song, I pour my heart. I sing my song, I pour my heart. We're never, ever, we're never, ever, we're never, ever apart. Don't you love this? Don't you love these songs? My buddy Steve Ford's gonna help me get these recorded. Wouldn't you like to be driving along singing these happy songs, huh? Wouldn't you? We're working on that. But we need everybody to say, hey, I want to chip in and help this Love Force Revolution. Now you know what it's about. It's not about me, and it's not about you as the human. It's about us as the spirit. And everyone is the spirit. So it's about our world, for sure. It's about all these cosmic babies, these bliss babies that come out of spirit, and we're here just to watch the movie of creation and never, ever suffer, to help them to realize what we are waking up to right here, that we are bliss babies, all right? We are Divine Mother Soul babies. We are happiness itself. We are joy itself. We are cosmic creations. We are cosmic creators, all right? There is nothing ever in the consciousness of the Creator that was meant to have us suffer, and what everyone else thinks is happening here is never, ever even an idea in the mind of the great cosmic joy and bliss, huh? So don't let it be an idea in yours. One more round. Somewhere, someone is always loving us. Somehow you know our name. I just think Infinite and I, man, the King and I walk along today. It knows everything about me because it is me, and I have this intimate relationship with the Infinite. Are you kidding me? That is one of the greatest, best news ever for anyone. I can hold a hand, I can snuggle up, I can go through my midlife crisis. After actually my senior crisis is now. With the Infinite. So it doesn't matter. There's no crisis with the Infinite. Somewhere, someone is always loving us, and somehow it knows our names. Oh, can you be for real? Can you be forever? Are you really the one for me? Oh, yeah, you are. Can you be for real? Can you be forever? Are you really the one for me? I'll sing my song, I'll pour my heart. I'll sing my song, I'll pour my heart. Cause we're never, ever apart. I'll sing my song, I'll pour my heart. I'll sing my song, I'll pour my heart. We're never, ever, we're never, ever, we're never, ever apart. I'll sing my song, I'll pour my heart. I'll sing my song, I'll pour my heart. Isn't that what we're doing here? It's certainly what Source has me doing. I'll sing my song, I'll pour my heart. For no reason, there's no strings. I'll sing my song, I'll pour my heart. Why? Because we're never, ever. I'll sing my song, I'll pour my heart. We're never, ever, we're never, ever, we're never, ever apart. The Love Force Revolution. It's the GitaStudy.com. It's the amazing manifestations that's going to come when we co-create and come together and stay in the love and the light and learn to live in our hearts more and more. We can do this together. We cannot do it isolated. And then let the manifestations come, whatever that may be, but with complete Bhagavad Gita wisdom. We don't do it. We're not doing it for anything. We are not attached to the fruits of our actions. Is spirit attached to anything, man? No, it's completely detached. It's free. It's free. Spirit is free. Hello, peoples of the earth. Spirit is free. Love is free. Happiness and joy and eternity is free. Now let's act our age. Let's act our divinity. Let's act our eternity and operate in this 3D realm accordingly. Wow. Well, I didn't get to comment with everyone. Hello, Marley. Hello, Mickey. But man and woman, oh soul, what a morning it's been. Then what? Right here, right now, the joy. Namaste.